Hi guys, I'm Raunak. So Brock Lesnar was set to challenge Roman Reigns for the Universal Championship. But with Roman Reigns, he tested positive for COVID-19. So Brock Lesnar's WWE title match against Roman Reigns at WWE's first pay-per-view event of the year, WWE Day 1, was cancelled. Following the cancellation, Brock Lesnar was added to the WWE title match, making it fatal 5-way match. The other stars featuring in that match were defending champion Big E, Seth Rollins, Kevin Owens and Bobby Lashley. Brock Lesnar, however, ended up winning the title and rose to the top once again. So with that said, here are 5 reasons why Brock Lesnar was chosen to defeat Big E in this particular clash. So let's get started. Paul Heyman said he has been keeping Roman Reigns safe from Brock Lesnar. Is that why he went out of his way to ensure that the Beast Incarnate had a shot at the other title so that he kept his meaty paws off his tribal chief? Paul Heyman claimed to be loyal to Roman Reigns, and this could be a strange way for the special counsel to showcase his commitment. When Roman Reigns is ready to return to the roster again, Paul Heyman could bring this up as a sign of his devotion. The fact he ensured that Brock Lesnar was removed from Universal title picture. There is a reason Brock Lesnar becomes the face of the company on a part-time schedule. Ever so often, it is because so many years since his debut, he is still a massive draw for WWE company. Not only does he become the face of WWE Raw now, but he could also continue to show up on SmackDown to boost ratings. Brock Lesnar seems more motivated than he has in years. So if he is willing to work a longer schedule, the future could be a lot of fun. WWE understands how big a showdown between Brock Lesnar and Bobby Lashley is. Fans have been asking for a contest like this for years, from before the time Bobby Lashley rejoined WWE. Yes, Brock Lesnar did win the match, but for a moment it seemed like Bobby Lashley was going to. You can rest assured that the story between these two men, Chelsea Doubt of Granite, is far from over. The reason why Brock Lesnar is still a proven draw after so many years is that he hardly ever loses. That's why it's hardly a surprise that he defeated 4 other competitors to become the WWE champion. A win was necessary on such a big stage, especially after the loss to Roman Reigns in Saudi Arabia. One has to believe if Roman Reigns vs Brock Lesnar was happening, the outcome would have been pretty much the same. We need to remember that Brock Lesnar was the man who ended Kofi Kingston's glorious reign as the WWE champion. Now he is responsible for bringing Big E's reign to an end as well. In a nutshell, there's a story to be explored here between the New Day and Brock Lesnar. Could one of the 3 be responsible for bringing the current reign to an end on a larger stage like WrestleMania 38? Brock Lesnar as WWE champion will surely give a much needed boost to Monday Night Raw, especially if headlined by a storyline between Lesnar and Lashley. On the other side of the things, continuing the story between Brock Lesnar, Roman Reigns and Paul Heyman, now around a world title unification match, would be the biggest possible way to culminate the incredible story on the biggest stage possible. Whichever route the WWE decides to take on the road WrestleMania this year, things have been certainly become more intriguing coming out of day one. If you're new to this channel, then subscribe it, leave a like. And why do you think the Beast Incarnate has been conferred with the WWE Championship? Feel free to share your thoughts and views in the comments below.